Hello, Homestead, and please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for a moment of silence.
Hello, Homestead. I'm Corey Stace.
And I'm Casey Stanley.
And on today's edition of HHS In-Depth, Drake White brings you a tech talk about Tech Fest 2014.
Bailey Hauser gets us all caught up on the winners of the Penny War that took place before spring break.
And we'll show you a couple announcements regarding next week's Poetry in Your Pocket and High School Radio Day programs taking place.
All of that and more on HHS In-Depth for Friday, April 18th.
So what did you do for your birthday last week?
I had some friends over. It was awesome. What'd you do?
I went out to dinner with
just I need your help with something in the classroom real quick. Can you come and help me?
Yes.
It's this way.
Happy birthday!
Woo!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday!
Guys, what's wrong? It's your birthday.
No, our birthday was yesterday. You guys all forgot.
Wait. I have the perfect birthday present for him. Stace, Casey, why don't you guys anchor?
That's fine. Totally makes up for you guys being awful friends and forgetting our birthdays.
Yeah, it does.
Happy birthday to you.
We start today's show by bringing you a special edition of Drake White's Tech Talk as he tells us about Tech Fest 2014.
Hello.
Drake, we need a tech lesson now.
I'll be right there.
Reporting for HHS In-Depth, I'm Drake White, and this week for our Tech Talk, we're not going to have a tech lesson. We're going to do a feature on the Tech Fest, which happened a few weeks ago downtown Fort Wayne.
Around 20 or 30 people that went, and it started at roughly 9, and that was when the opening ceremony was. And then after that, you could either go to a 50-minute lecture or you could go through the career fair.
The day was basically, it was a lot of fun. I mean, first we got to skip school, which is good. I mean, everyone loves to skip school. We got to... Besides the certain events that people from Homestead have participated in, we got to go to breakout sessions, which breakout sessions were basically different groups that you could choose to go to that prepared you for the future. I mean, they guided you. People gave out business cards if you needed any help with maybe starting your own business.
And how the points standards were, there was you get so many points for going and getting a stamp from each section or each station at the Career Center, or you could get points from sitting through a 50-minute lecture and getting stamps there. And then you also got points for your competition. And the group of four people that I was with for the video game design didn't end up placing, but overall our school got third.
We created a Doge-themed game. It was like going through civilization, and you did wars and all that, and it was based off of Doge, obviously. And what we did is we just created technology, and you go through the years and get more inventions and all that. We didn't place as high as we wanted to, but we still got third.
Reporting for HHS In-Depth, I'm Drake White.
The Point 91 FM WCYT t-shirts are on sale now in the radio station room 600B. Shirts cost $10 each or $25 for all three colors.
Attention seniors, it's not too late to apply for Mr. Spartan in the Senior Variety Show. Please see Ms. Hagen in Student Services for more details.
Attention seniors, this is the last chance for your family to congratulate you on your outstanding 4 years at Homestead and commemorate your achievements forever in this year's yearbook. Due to high demand, the yearbook staff has decided to extend the deadline for senior wishes for one final week. Senior wishes must be turned in no later than Monday, April 21st. Hurry, time is running out.
And now here is Bailey Hauser to share results of the Penny Wars that took place before spring break. Did your class win? Find out now.
Hello, Homestead. Bailey Hauser here. You may recall a few weeks prior to spring break the Penny War contest that took place here at Homestead High School. Well, I'm here to announce the winners. The fifth period class that won was Mrs. Merkling's class, who won with a point total of 16,761. Her class raised a total of $181.61. Mrs. Crawford's class was second with $104.01. The two classes that raised the most money were clearly victims of sabotage. Mrs. Valencik-Miller's class raised $502.53, while Mrs. Squire's class raised a total of $326.92. And now I'm here with Mrs. Valencik-Miller with a special announcement on behalf of student government.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to reach out to you guys and thank you for the support during Pennies for Patients. Although I can't disclose the actual total until after the campaign is over, I did want to tell you that it was an unbelievable amount. It's the most we've ever raised, and I am excited to disclose that amount after May 30th. So again, I just really want to thank you guys and all the teachers who supported and rallied around the cause, and all the students who emptied their pockets for such a great cause. Saturday, I was in an event with Gianna and Caleb, both suffering from leukemia at the time, and it's a really warm, endearing thought to know that we are helping them. The money goes to support a great cause, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Valencik-Miller.
Attention seniors, it is not too late to apply for Mr. Spartan and the Senior Variety Show. Please see Ms. Hagen in Student Services for more details.
Next week, Key Club and the Network are teaming up to raise money for Wellspring Interfaith Food Bank. We will be raising money during fifth period classes. Whichever class raises the most money will get to pie Mr. Ginder in the face on the video announcements.
All cast of the fall play, The Mouse That Roared, please stop by Mrs. Malooly's room by the end of the day today to cast your vote for People's Choice Award for the fall play. Thank you.
Intramural flag football team packets are available at Discipline Office across from the IMC. Packets are due to Mrs. Mathias in the Discipline Office by the end of the day today.
Seniors, the Deer Ridge PTA scholarship deadline is approaching. If you attended Deer Ridge Elementary School, go to the SAC's website and click on the scholarship listing for details.
And now here are two promotional videos for programs taking place here at school next week. National High School Radio Day and Poetry in Your Pocket Day.
All right, this poem's called True Friends by Leigh Marie. True friends will never fall short. They're always there through thick and thin, hard times and easy times.
Trying to match the dubbing to the big lips shining down from the screen.
I'm waking up, I feel it in my bones, enough to make my systems grow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age, welcome to the new age, to the new age. Whoa, 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 whoa. Radioactive, radioactive.
Mine is called There Is No Word by Tony Hogan. There isn't a word for walking out of the grocery store with a gallon jug of milk in a plastic sack.
This is by Kenneth Cook, one of my favorite New York School of Poets. It's kind of a love poem, so this one's for my Catherine. It's called
Words Come Out Like Baby, There's a Shark in the Water. There's something underneath my bed. Oh, please believe I said.
This is the Point 91 FM. What's up, Fort Wayne? I'm Liz Krueger, going to be your DJ here for the next hour. A couple quick announcements before I kick off the next song. High School Radio Day is coming up on April 23rd, where we'll celebrate all the high school radio stations out there, which, believe it or not, we are indeed one here. We'll be having an open house at WCYT Studios within Homestead. You can talk to DJs, learn more about the station, and even get some super spiffy shirts, which are indeed selling out very quickly. So hurry up and get one before it's too late. Join us from 3 to 6 p.m. Enter through door 1 and we'll get you up in here. Once again, the date is April 23rd. It's at Homestead High School. Be sure to check us out. Coming up next year, we have Lucius with Will the Woman here on the Point 91 FM, where music is the point.
Hey, Casey. Speaking of Radio Day, aren't you going to be there?
Yeah, totally. Are you?
Yeah, I'm going to be there.
Everybody who's anybody's going to be there.
Yeah, really. And you can buy one of these shirts. Well, that wraps up this edition of HHS In Depth. I'm Corey Stace.
And I'm Casey Stanley. Have a great day, and we'll see you next week.
And today, we leave you with a song that can only be heard on The Point 91 FM.
Thank you.